Okay, so in the yesterday's class, what we discussed, ma'am? We just discussed about the phasor diagram, how to draw the phasor diagram for the different loading conditions. That is for the three load conditions we discussed in yesterday's class. For the resistive loads, or we can say that for unity power factors. For the inductive loads, or we can say that for the lagging power factors. For capacitive loads, or else for the leading power factors. Since in the case of resistance, the voltage and current phasors which will be in phase, we are calling for the resistive loads are also called as unity power factors. Always the pure resistance which offers the unity power factor. And similarly, the inductive loads, in the case of inductive loads, always the current behavior is in lag with the voltage. Always current lags the voltage in case of inductors. So therefore, the type of power factor in the inductance type of loads, we will get it as lagging power factor. So therefore, we can call it the inductance as a lagging power factor load. Similarly, in the case of capacitor, the current behavior is the current which leads the voltage by angle called as power factor angle pi. So what will be the power factor in the case of capacitive loads? We will get the leading power factors. So the capacitors which are called as which offer the leading power factor. So for these different types of power factors, how to construct that? That is by considering the leakage reactance and as well as the winding resistance, both primary and as well as the secondary circuits. By considering the winding resistance and as well as the leakage reactance, how to construct the vector diagram we just discussed. So if you have any doubt in the last class, you can ask me. Else we will continue with the next topic. Okay. So in today's class, we will just discuss about the equivalent circuit of the transformer. So just to draw how first we will discuss how to draw the equivalent circuit or how we will represent the equivalent circuit of the transformer. Then what are the various testings that we conduct on the transformer to find these equivalent circuit parameters. And I wanted to represent all the circuit parameters both with respect to primary alone and as well as the secondary alone. It means whatever the secondary circuit parameters that I have, if I wanted to shift onto the primary circuit, what will be the consequence? And similarly, the total circuit parameters on the primary, if I shift onto the secondary circuit, then what the parameters, that is how the circuit parameters that will be changed, what the changes that to be made, and how to derive the equivalent circuit either with respect to primary and as well as the secondary that we will discuss. Okay, so this is the diagram. Here we can go through the diagram which explains you the equivalent circuit of the transformer. So what is the equivalent circuit? The circuit or pictorial diagram which represents the complete parameters which includes is called as the equivalent circuit. It is a circuit which represents the equivalent circuit. Okay, this is called as the equivalent circuit of the transformer. Now see here in this one, this R1 and X1 which represents the primary resistance and as well as the primary reactance. Okay. This V1 which represents the primary input voltage I'm applying to the transformer. Okay. As we already know, the phasor addition of resistance and reactance which is called as the impedance. So with respect to primary, if you add vectorially the resistance and reactance, then the primary circuit impedance of the transformer we will get, that is represented with the Z1. Okay, and these are the no load parameters, that is R0 and as well as the X0. So this is working component of current which is flowing through the R0, and this is magnetizing component of current which is flowing through the X0. Okay, and this coil which represents the primary winding. So when we are applying the input voltage, the primary current which will flows. Okay, this will produce the flux in the primary winding of the transformer, resulting in production of the statically induced EMF in the primary winding, that winding voltage which we are representing with E1. This is E1, statically EMF induced in the primary winding of the transformer. And these two lines, what it represents actually, transformer core. This is primary winding, this is secondary winding. These two parallel lines in between primary and secondary winding, which represents the transformer core. Without core, we cannot wind the winding, right? So definitely to wind this coil, we require the transformer core, and the transformer core, we will wind the winding. So these two lines we have to represent when we are representing the transformer, and these two lines which represents the transformer core. Okay. And this is the secondary winding coil. Okay. due to mutual induction, there will be an induced EMF in the secondary also. Already we discussed that concept in the principle of operation. So this E2, which represents the amount of induced voltage in the secondary winding, and this R2, which represents the secondary coil resistance, this X2 represents the secondary winding or the secondary coil reactance, inductive reactance, and the vector addition of this R2 and X2 is nothing but called as impedance. So since this R2 and X2, which represents the resistance and the inductive reactance of the respectively the that is resistance and inductive reactance respectively of the secondary winding, this Z2 also represents the impedance of the secondary winding. And see here, we have connected a load, and this load, which is represented with ZL. So this E2 is nothing but the induced voltage in the secondary winding. This V2 is nothing but the secondary terminal voltage, which is called as V2. This type of load, which will depends, either resistive load we can put, or a combination of resistance and inductance, or resistance and capacitance, or different kind of loads. In based on the requirement, we will place the load on the transformer. Okay. Now this complete circuit, which represents all the parameters of the transformer, and this circuit what we know as equivalent circuit of the transformer. Now all the parameters, that is all the primary parameters, we represented on the primary side. All the secondary parameters we represented on the secondary side. Now for my convenience, I just wanted to represent all the parameters either with respect to primary or else with respect to secondary. See here, in this diagram, it will be very clear. If you observe this diagram, it will be very clear for you. Now, is there represented the secondary parameters on the secondary winding side? No. The secondary winding parameters which are I have, R2, X2, and as well as the terminal voltage, this impedance, all these parameters have shifted onto the primary circuit, and these secondary parameters also are represented on the primary side. So if I shift this secondary circuit parameters to the primary side, will these values is going to be changes? Yes. Actually, there is some conditions while shifting one circuit parameter to another. Here in this first diagram, I have shifted the secondary resistance and secondary reactance to the primary side. I am representing these parameters on the primary side. So there are some conditions actually while shifting the secondary circuit parameters to the primary side. Similarly, this is the circuit diagram which shows you representation of representation of the equivalent circuit with respect to secondary. See here I have the load R2 and X2. As usual, I have shifted the primary resistance and reactance onto the secondary circuit. So in this circuit diagram, I have represented the primary circuit elements, how shifted to the secondary circuit, and with respect to secondary, this is what the circuit diagram or equivalent circuit diagram. This is what the equivalent circuit diagram with respect to primary. So what the conditions that we have when we are shifting one circuit element to the another circuit, that we will discuss now. So till now, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Illivarigu now discuss madidralli enadru doubt idre kelbodha manu. Is any doubt we have? ಯಾರಿಗಾದ್ರೂ ಏನಾದರೂ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಹಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಮಿ ಆರ್ ಯು ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಮೈ ವಾಯ್ಸ್
Yes, sir.
Any doubt in the concept just we discussed? No. No doubt, Amma. If you don't have any doubt, tell me no doubt, sir. Then I will continue with the session.
No, sir.
Okay. Fine. Right. So if you carefully observe these diagrams, first let us discuss representation of equivalent circuit with respect to primary side. See, we applied the input voltage V1, primary current, primary resistance, primary inductive reactance, primary impedance, representation of the no load parameters R0 and X0, IW and IMU, same as it is. Illivari namge enide namma same till this, whatever the primary circuit is there, the same circuit we will get here. Now this secondary resistance and reactance I wanted to shift onto the primary side. So I am shifting the secondary parameters onto the primary circuit. So if you shift the value of resistance in the secondary winding to the primary, then that value of resistance, which is called as R2 dash. Suppose R2 value, if it is equals to 10 and then coloring, if I shift that resistance to the primary circuit, it will not equals to 10. It is another value of resistance. Change in the value of resistance will be that new value of resistance with respect to primary is called as R2 dash. This R2 dash is nothing but called as the resistance of the secondary with respect to primary. Secondary winding resistance with respect to primary is called as R2 dash. So here I am representing this R2. 2 represents the secondary winding resistance. Secondary winding resistance, this dash represents with respect to another circuit. So rather than to represent this secondary winding resistance on the secondary side, I am shifting this value to the primary side, and that value of resistance is called as the new value of resistance. It is R2 dash. It is called as this R2 dash is nothing but the secondary resistance with respect to primary. Similarly, X2 is the amount of secondary resistance we have. I am shifting this resistance to the primary side. So if you shift that reactance to the primary side, then the new value of reactance, what we are calling it as X2 dash. This X2 dash is nothing but the value of secondary reactance with respect to primary side. Similarly, I2 is nothing but the secondary load current or secondary current or load current we are calling it as. So this I2 current, if you shift onto the primary side, then it is called as I2 dash. This I2 dash is nothing but the equivalent secondary circuit current with respect to primary. Similarly, V2 is the secondary voltage. So if you shift onto the primary side, then the new value of voltage which will becomes V2 dash. Similarly, ZL is the amount of impedance with respect to secondary. So if you shift to the primary, then the new value of impedance, which is called as ZL dash. So this is the value of load impedance with respect to primary circuit. Okay. So this total circuit diagram, which represents the equivalent circuit with respect to primary side. Okay. Now we will discuss about the equivalent circuit with respect to the secondary side. So how to calculate these values of R2 dash, X2 dash, I2 dash and as well as ZL dash, I will tell you in detail. First, let me show you the equivalent circuit, how we are going to get, and then I will tell you how to convert this one circuit resistance to the another circuit. Okay. So this is, if you go through this is the equivalent circuit diagram with respect to the secondary side. Okay. This is referred to the secondary side. So see here, V1 I have shifted to the secondary, that will becomes V1 dash. Okay. This I1 represented, actually this is I1 dash, wrongly it was represented, it will becomes I1 dash. Okay. And this is R1, right? So if you shift onto the secondary, it will becomes R1 dash. X1, if you shift onto the secondary side, it will becomes X1 dash. So a vector addition of these two, which is called as Z1 dash. So what is R1 dash is nothing but it is equal to, R1 is nothing but primary resistance. So the primary resistance you are representing on the secondary circuit side. So this is the value of primary resistance with respect to the secondary side. So this is the value of inductive reactance of the primary with respect to the secondary. This is the impedance, that is the primary impedance with respect to the secondary side. Similarly, R0 and X0 also have shifted onto the secondary side, that is R0 dash and X0 dash it will become. Okay. And same E1 and E2 I have represented. Similarly, R2 and X2 as it is we will get. The vector addition of both these two is nothing but Z2, and this is I2 and this is ZL. Voltage across this load is equal to called as V2, nothing but the terminal voltage. Okay. So next, these are for ideal transformer that we have derived. Now approximate equivalent circuit with respect to both primary and as well as the secondary. Now if you go through, then it will becomes look, it looks like this. Now this is the circuit which is called as approximate equivalent circuit with respect to primary. Actually, what is the equivalent circuit with respect to primary? I have This is the circuit, right? So this is the complete circuit diagram with respect to primary. This is the complete circuit diagram with respect to secondary. So in the primary circuit now, how this R1 and R2 dash looks like? They are connected. Looks, if you neglect this no load parameters, actually this is the approximate circuit which we have developed. It means that these no load circuit parameters have shifted to here. Then R1 and R2 dash which will be connected in series. So R1 and R2 dash which will be connected in series means what will be the resultant resistance? R1 plus R2 dash. So that R1 plus R2 dash, which is the, here I have connected. This is R1, this is R2 dash. Similarly, X1 and X2 dash which will be connected in series, X1 and X2 dash that will be get connected in series. Okay. So this is primary circuit impedance. This is secondary circuit impedance with respect to primary. I2 dash as it is we will have. This is I1, this is I0, R0 and X0. The simple, what is the assumption that we have taken? So if you neglect this I0 means we can shift the same parameters to here. Okay. So I'm considering that in the ideal case, I'm considering this I0 is the negligible in current value. So I shifted these no load parameters to here. Then the approximate equivalent circuit, then we can derive that approximate circuit which resulting in the value of primary resistance and secondary resistance with respect to primary, which will be connected in series. Similarly, the primary reactance and as well as the secondary reactance with respect to primary, which will be connected in series. So if I add this R1 and R2 dash, then the resultant resistance is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. So R1 plus R2 dash, this R1 plus R2 dash, which is equal to R01. So what is this R01 is equal to? This is the value which is equal to R1 plus R2 dash. So what is R1 plus R2 dash? This is primary resistance. This is secondary resistance with respect to primary. So this R01, which represents the total resistance with respect to primary. So R01, which consists of both primary resistance and as well as the secondary resistance. So this R01, which is equal to what? R1 plus R2 dash. And this R01, which is called as the total value of resistance with respect to primary winding. Similarly, X01. What is X01 is equal to? X1 plus X2 dash. So X1 plus X2 dash is equal to what? X1 is the primary resistance. X2 dash is the secondary, X1 is the primary reactance and X2 dash is nothing but secondary reactance with respect to primary. So X1 plus X2 dash which resulting in gives you the total value of reactance with respect to primary. So X01 which represents the value of total reactance with respect to the primary winding. So if you can combine this, then the total impedance with respect to primary winding we will get. Same. Here I consider that ZL, secondary impedance if you convert to here, then it is ZL dash actually. This is I2 dash. I2 dash is equal to I2 by K. Already we know that relation. And this is V2 dash. Here V2 dash I have represented. V1 as it is we have. This is I1. This is I0. This is I2 dash. I0 plus I2 dash is equal to I1. Right? So this is about how we can develop the approximate equivalent circuit by considering a assumptions. Okay, so this is the ideal case actually for the practical transformers. Slightly these values that will be get varies. So we have considered some assumptions, and by considering those assumptions, these are the approximate equivalent circuits that we can derive for the transformer. So this is the equivalent circuit with respect to primary. Now you can get you will have a doubt. That is if I shift the value of secondary resistance R2 to the primary, the new value of resistance I'm representing with respect to primary as R2 dash. So if I shift the secondary resistance to the primary, will the value of resistance get changes? Yes. That new value of resistance we are representing with R2 dash. So this R2 dash which is going to be equals to, what this value which is going to be equals to? R2 dash which is equal to R2 divided by K square. Here R2 which represents the secondary resistance and K which represents the transformation ratio of the transformer. So if I wanted to calculate the new value of resistance of the secondary winding with respect to primary, I need to divide with the square of the transformation ratio of the secondary winding resistance. Then the new value of resistance that I will get. Similarly for the reactance also, X2 dash I will get which is equal to X2 divided by K k square. Similarly, z2 dash is equal to z2 divided by k square. This is how the new value of resistances and reactance and impedance values that we can calculate after shifting one circuit parameters to the another circuit. Suppose if I shift the primary circuit elements to the secondary circuit, rather than to here, secondary to primary, if you shift, then the new value of resistance, if I wanted to calculate, then it should be divided with the square of the transformation ratio. And if I wanted to shift from primary to secondary, then it should be multiplied with the square of the transformation ratio. You can observe here, r1 dash, which is equal to k square r1, and similarly, x1 dash is equal to k square x1, z1 dash is equal to k square z1. And the oldest terms, which is represented, which is already we know, e1 dash, which is k is equal to what? E1 dash divided by e2. So from which e1 dash is equal to k into e1 we will get. And from this approximate formula, approximate circuit diagram, what is r01 is equal to r1 plus r2 dash. Similarly, what is x01 is equal to x1 plus x2 dash. So x01 is equal to x1 plus x2 dash. And similarly, what is this z01 is equal to z1 plus z2 dash. So z01 is equal to z1 plus z2 dash. Similarly, r02 is equal to r2 plus r1 dash. X02 is equal to x2 plus x1 dash. Z02 is equal to z2 plus z1 dash. So till now, what the concepts that we discussed, if you have any doubt, you can just unmute and you can ask me. ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ಅಫೀಫಾ
ಸರ್
ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಸರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೆ ಸರ್
ಸಾರಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದು ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಲಿಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸಲ ಕೇಳಿ ಅಫೀಫಾ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಮೀ
ಸರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೆ ಸರ್
ಕೆ ಮಾ ಕೆ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ In the beginning of the classes we discussed, no? Let me show you. K is the transformation ratio. See here, n2 by n1, which is nothing but K. Terms ratio or transformation ratio anta karithivala. N2 by n1, or it is equal to E2 by E1, or it is equals to I1 by I2. This N2 by N1 is nothing but called as K. K is called as transformation ratio or turns ratio. Okay, next. Inna. Leelavati. ಲೀಲಾವತಿ ಲೀಲಾವತಿ ಆರ್ ಯು ದೇರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲೈನ್ ಲತಾಶ್ರೀ
ಸರ್ ನೋ ಸರ್
ನೋ ಡೌಟ್ ಅಮ್ಮ
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಅದೇ ಕೇಳಿದಷ್ಟೇ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಅವಳೇ ಕೇಳಿದ್
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ
ಹಾ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾಲಿನ್ ಸ್ಟಾಲಿನ್ So shall I move on to the next topic?
Okay, sir.
Okay, okay, fine, fine. So this is about equivalent circuit and shifting one circuit elements to the other circuit. Now, before going to discuss about voltage regulation and efficiency, first we will discuss about the testing of transformer. I will show you the testing. Transformer tests. Okay, what is mean by test? Why we'll do usually a testing? Testing usually we will conduct on a particular device to find something, right? So if I wanted to find some efficiency of the transformer, and or else if I want to find some regulation of the transformer, if I wanted to find the characteristics of the transformer, then I will conduct some test onto the transformer and I will find the result from the test. I will get some data using that test data. What we conduct on the particular equipment, we'll using the formula we can calculate and we can derive the characteristics also. So similarly, in order to find all the, that is all the parameters like efficiency, regulation and all those things, we'll conduct the transformer test. There are two important tests we have on we have to conduct on the transformer. One is called as open circuit test, which is called as OC test. Next one is a short circuit test, which is called as SC test. Okay, so these two tests which we are going to conduct onto the transformer to find out the voltage regulation and as well as the efficiency. So already we know what is mean by the efficiency, right? What is efficiency? Why we need to calculate that? Efficiency is nothing but is any idea from any student? How we will calculate the efficiency of a particular device?
It is the ratio of the output to the input.
Ratio of output power to the input power.
Input.
So here we are calculating the electrical efficiency, right? So in order to calculate the efficiency of the transformer, how we will calculate in generally, it is the ratio of output power divided by the input power to the device. And as here we are calculating for transformer means output power of the transformer divided by input power giving or input power applying to the transformer into 100. Here always efficiency we will calculate in terms of a percentage, right? So into 100 or multiply with, if you multiply that ratio with the 100, then we will get the percentage efficiency of the transformer. So now I wanted to find out the efficiency of the transformer. How can we find that? We can find by conducting the tests onto the transformer. And what are the various tests that we are conducting to find the efficiency of the transformer? Two tests we need to conduct. With only any one of the tests, we are unable to find the efficiency. Both tests we have to conduct to find out the efficiency. So if you know the results of open circuit test and as well as the short circuit test, then it is possible or be able to find the efficiency of the transformer. Similarly, what is voltage regulation? Already the definition for voltage regulation we know, right? What is voltage regulation? It is the ratio of voltage regulation. You can go through here. What is voltage regulation? It is the ratio of, or we can say that the change in the secondary terminal voltage from no load. This is not V2, which represents the no load voltage, no load secondary voltage. This V2 represents full load voltage. So from the difference between the no load to the full load voltage, if you divide with the no load voltage, then we will get the regulation. Okay. So the change in secondary terminal voltage from no load to full load, that is zero, this zero which represents not no load secondary terminal voltage, this is secondary terminal voltage on load. So the difference in the no load terminal voltage to the full load, if you get the difference, that difference if you divide it with the no load terminal voltage, then the value of regulation we will get. So why we need to calculate this regulation? Always, for the better operation of the transformer, this always the regulation of the transformer or regulation of any particular device should be as less of as possible. Why? Because we wanted the same value of voltage even on the no load or even on the load condition. So no load, during the no load and full load, if you have the same voltage value, then the regulation value which will become zero, or it is a very lower value, right? So higher the voltage regulation means higher the difference in the numerator term. It means that that particular device is having more difference of voltage from the no load to the full load condition. So that is undesirable one. So always for any device, the regulation value to be as less of that as possible. Always we needed better efficiency means higher the efficiency we should have, it should be nearer or it should be equal to equal or nearer to 100 it should be. And regulation always it should be as minimum as possible. So it should be nearer to zero or zero if you have, then we can say it is a better device. Okay. So these transformer tests which we are conducting, it is helpful in finding out the both efficiency and as well as the regulation of the transformer. So what is this open circuit test and what are the various conditions that we have while conducting this open circuit test, and what are the test data that we will derive, and from the test data how we will find the efficiency and as well as the voltage regulation in the coming classes we will discuss. Okay, is it clear, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
It is clear, right, all of you? So in the next class, first I will what are the various tests that we are conducting, that I will tell you. After that, what are the conditions, or what are the test data that we will derive from that, using that test data how we will find the efficiency and as well as the regulation, that I will tell you. Okay, so with this I'm ending my session. And if you don't have any doubt, you can sign off from your session. I'm just stopping the recording.